How is it for you to live in America? Because in New York, is it of any influences?
No. But I did also my balance because, first of all, New York is not really America, and then I'm surrounded with European people all the time. So it's my little balance.
Yeah, is Berlin of any influence on you guys? Because you lived there for so long. Is that of any influence on your lyrics or just the culture there?
Yeah, I think it is. Berlin, our roots. Some of our members, they're born and raised there. And we lived there a long time already. And I think, yeah, the town has some influence on you, but I can't describe what. Maybe a Berlin band should sound like Rammstein.
Yeah, because the city is very hot, I guess, nowadays, with the new thing and rebuilding and the architecture.
Yeah, many people coming there meet each other. And the music scene is growing a lot in Berlin, and like our companies moved there, and there's a lot of new bands coming up and projects, electro projects, and a lot of things going on.
And can you tell something about the artwork? Well, because mostly the artwork is very special for you guys.
The artwork in
just for the CD, just a booklet and that kind of stuff.
First of all, I have to say the first art thing we did was for the first video, because normally, you know, you have a treatment and you, like, especially with Rammstein, we're always shooting like videos in a kind of story way of but this time we chose a totally different way, and we said, okay, listen, like, we make a dance performance. Everyone could have like 2 hours of moving to the songs.
Okay.
And it's kind of arty, I guess.
Yeah. What was it for? Maintal, the single.
Exactly, it was Maintal.
They were looking for the double ganger for you.
Yeah, I was looking for a double ganger. Yeah, because I was ending up like wrestling against myself, so I needed like some wrestler. So, but the other thing, like the cover and all the other stuff, we at the development right now, so we haven't really decided any direction. We just do a lot as we can right now, and then hopefully things coming together, and we feel that's the right way.
Okay. Can you lift up the curtain a little bit about which ideas, what kind of ideas?
For example, like we're going on a weekend to working the first time with a Spanish photographer, and he's really, really interesting. So, so I'm really curious about what he's coming up. And there's one way of doing things. And then we thought about like name the record as Rise Riser, which also brings you in this whole journey, travel business. But we are not sure about right now. So we're still looking for themes that kind of fit together.
Okay.
And you know, sometimes you need time because that's the way it is.
Just a couple of questions about the songs, because I've heard Los and the last song Amour. And it's really like Amour. It's a very special song, I guess. It sounds like a second single.
Yeah. Oh, interesting. Yeah, this song was good in the beginning, and then during the whole production, we didn't really like it, and we were really tried a lot of things, and in the end, turned out very surprising well. And I really liked that song too. And could it be contender?
Is it difficult to keep it fresh for you guys, because it's a really new direction? Some of the songs, for instance, Amour, it's a really new direction.
Yeah, it is. That's what I said. We tried out so many things, so many ways, and we were open just doing it and don't censoring anything before. We gave a chance to a lot of new dimensions, and before we would have said, oh no, this doesn't sound Rammstein, let's do more like that, and this and so we found
especially the song reflects also a little bit the work that we did, because we were so many years slave to computers and machines, and especially this song, it was really about playing, like be a guitar player or be a drummer.
Oh.
rather than, you know, follow the machine. So it was, it's really about playing, and you can hear it if you listen to track. It's playing.
Yeah.
It's really simple, but it's like you can hear. You can hear it. So
just the organic feel, I guess.
Exactly.
Okay. That's a little bit of the central, the message of you guys, the organic feel, or.
I think that's one of the things we want to try to say, that we are, first of all, we are back, and we are more human than people think we are. Maybe.
Okay. I forget. I could just there was a Pet Shop Boys remix for Maintal. Is it true?
Yes. Yeah. They remixed one song, and Arthur Baker may remix one song.
Why those two?
Why not?
Yeah. You like the work of Pet Shop Boys?
I like it. Yeah. Well. Yeah.
It's very poppy, also.
Yeah, it's pop music, but great pop music, and yeah, that is also lasting pop music, I think.
Yeah.
And there is a special link. There is a little story behind, but it's not that interesting. It's
you can tell it's just
we ask them, and because they are working for a movie project right now, where they wanted to have some symphonic music, and on that research they found out that we had a symphonic project too going on in the last year. There is a record came out from the young composer Thorsten Rasch. Is it the right name? Thorsten or Günther? Thorsten Rasch. Mm-hmm. And he used Rammstein lyrics for a special cycle of symphonic songs, like a bit in the way of Mahler and like that, and but very modern symphonic. It's not easy to listen to, and the Pet Shop Boys, they want to do something in that direction for that movie, and so they want to work with the same producer and that same orchestra, and that we use that chance to ask them, maybe they can remix that single, and on that single there are also elements of squires from that orchestra. So, and there was kind of artistic interest in each other. So
I've also heard in one of the songs, I also heard some choirs. That was very nice. One of the last songs.
That's also a new element in Rammstein. We recorded the choirs, which is always has been a part of our music, but this time we did a live recording of them, and it sounds so much more big and natural than the sampler instruments, and give the music more spirit, more organic, extra. Yeah.
One of the last songs also, I guess, Los. I hear a harmonica or something, or is the keyboard? But it's one of the end.
It's a real harmonica.
Okay. Very strange.
Country music.
Okay, German country music. just a couple of questions. Do you want to record some? How do you call it? A track for a film or a movie? Because some of the songs are very, like movie-like.
Can choose the movies. Normally the movies choosing us, so hopefully this time will be the same. But yeah, we always like really happy about to work in a movie project or whatever. Last time we did on Treble X, we also could actually play in the movie, which was quite fun. So I think Rammstein music general, like, think works really well with music, because it's such a big picture you can have, and they're always welcome to ask us.
Any names? Which one movie? I don't know. Which movie do you want to score?
I have no idea, because I don't know the movies.
Okay, doesn't matter.
The movies, they're coming. So maybe there are interesting directors. Maybe Tarantino will choose Rammstein. That would be great.
Who knows?
Kill Bill.
Kill Bill. Yeah, Kill Bill 3 with Rammstein. Okay, nice. Artwork favorite. And where do you listen to yourselves, actually?
We
What kind of groups do you listen to? Because
it's really different. The last thing I actually liked was the new record from Killing Joke. I was pretty enjoying. Yeah, it was pretty cool. But again, it's changing every time. So right now there was one record I really liked.
So. Okay, and then just the last, what do you think about the internet actually? Because some see it as a danger. People downloading music, record sales are down. How do you approach that the beast of internet?
Internet is the internet. It is there, and it's a part of our entertainment now. You can say, and I'm not afraid. Things will be solved. People downloading, of course, but you need to make sure the record industry need to make sure they are selling the music in the internet and controlling a little bit more the things, because for us musicians it's important that we can sell the music and not give it away just as a present, because it's also work behind and a lot of money behind it is. Just any other product you have to buy. When you want to drink a coffee, you have to buy the coffee, and when you when you buy a jeans, you have to buy the jeans. You can't just take it.
And you have a lot of fan sites also.
Fan sites. Yeah, it's true.
Type in Rammstein on Google, then.
It's interesting which format the future gonna bring us. Now it's so many ways to store music and to it's a bit confusing. And you can do it like this, you can do it like this, you can have an MP3, you can there, and you can have a telephone, and I don't know what to do anymore.
I want to take my chance here to say something about downloading, because I think it's time that we start to also educate people a little bit more, because I mean, you totally understand if something is free to take it, you know, but the problem is that as I said before, like music sometimes requires a lot of work, so sometimes you're spending whatever 1,000 hours on a song, and people just think, you know, they can take it and steal it, which is not really cool, and in the end they will be responsible as well, that because the quality of music will go down, because nobody has really money to develop any bands anymore, and especially in rock music you need to support as well to develop those bands. So I think that I really don't understand why it happened that people, for example, stealing music on the other end and then paying like €2 for like a ringtone for a mobile phone. That's something I totally don't understand, and I think it's not really cool. But I do think that the internet's important, and it's a big, big tool in our generation. But they have to be educated and say, you know, that's not cool to steal music. So.
Okay. And Polo, just a couple of questions about the fire Polo techniques. Are you gonna work? Are you gonna do it in the tour?
Continue being a big live band and having pyrotechnics and having our live show. For sure, we will do that.
Have you already got some new ideas about the new?
We are in the planning.
When can we expect Rammstein in Holland?
We start our big tour from November, and it will be November, December this year. But I don't know when we come to Holland.
How is it actually in the U.S.?
Excuse me.
How is it actually in the U.S. with the Rammstein?
What do you mean, like with the
just the popularity?
Oh, it worked really fine for a specific time, and as you know, like American market is really fast, so you meet a lot of people like really fast, but they're always forgetting you as well. But the good thing about Rammstein is still kind of a cult band, especially for kids there. They really like it, and. It's a really difficult market, so you have to play and you have to spend a lot of time there, especially as a not American band. Especially after 11 September, you totally felt like that all of a sudden, like the American audience wasn't really open enough for a European product anymore. Yeah. Really kind of, you know, stuck in their own market, and I think they still have this crisis in a way, so it's time maybe to wake up.
Yeah. How did you react in the beginning when you first started in the US?
We definitely have a big fans there, like a fan base exactly. And but it's something also like really really difficult for us because we have to have the whole Rammstein ship to bring over, and it also requires a lot of time and money and all this kind of stuff. So you know, we always need a plan.
And how is it actually for you guys? Because you first did all the pyrotechnics all by yourselves. Mm-hmm. How is it now? Is it much more luxurious? Or
no, we had a little accident after a while, and then we realized, you know, we learned our lesson. Yeah. And then we said, listen, you know, we need like some professional people that kind of control it. I mean, the most ideas coming from the band, but then we need a company that, you know, is insured, for example, you know, and all this stuff. You know, there is like accidents, you know, have you heard of this band Great White in America that like they use pyrotechnic and all of a sudden the whole club was burned. For example, you know, those thing you can't really do. So we have to be really careful because, I mean, fire is not really controllable and, you know, sometimes you...
Okay, I guess next plans will be just promotion, I guess. The album is coming out 20th of September, is that true?
Yes, that's true.
And the new single is like 28th of June or
Mantile. That's going to be the single. Yeah.
Okay, nice. Yeah, I just have to thank you very very much for your time.
You're very well welcome, and say hello to your fans and to our fans. And we will be back in November.